Hey, God bless you out there. Hello out there. New prophecy from the throne room out there in North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, Far East. For the glory be to God. New prophecy from the throne room. Shout it from the mountaintops. New prophecy from Lisa Brother Ministry, Pinckney, Illinois. They'll go out to the four corners of the earth and the world for the glory be to God. Prophecy on Muslim nuclear winner. You heard it straight from the throne room here in Lister Brethren Ministry headquarters in Pinckneyville, Illinois. You won't see this on TV. You won't see nobody talking this on the internet or on the radio or newspapers. For the glory be to God. What we're seeing happening is for God's glory. And God touched me yesterday, gave me some new fresh manna from the throne room in 20 minutes. And I'm going to read it today on prophecy on a Muslim nuclear winner. Here it is, straight from the throne room. Here's God's anointed miracle. It's fresh manna from heaven. The God of Israel give this to me in 20 minutes on September the 17th, 2012. Rosh Hashanah. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sound an alarm at God's holy mount. Here it is. Prophecy on Muslim nuclear winner. New world order paying Muslim brotherhood to start a Muslim revolution in the Middle East. The Muslim nuclear winter clouds are gathering soon for the global eyes to see. The sign from the God of Israel is Rosh Hashanah, Rosh Hashanah, the new Jewish year, Rosh Hashanah. Blow the trumpet in Zion and sound alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, and it's nigh at hand. The Muslim Brotherhood, holy rollers, will set ablaze the Middle East with oil wells burning with black smoke. The battle for the Strait of Hormuz are gathering with 25 nations of war machines, getting ready for the dark storm clouds of the Muslims' nuclear winter. The next 12 days, we are at the point of no return. If Iran strikes first, the Yom-Kippur, high holy day of atonement, could be ground zero for Iran. If Israel doesn't strike on Yom-Kippur, then the nuclear D-Day could be before November the 1st, 2012, right before the presidential election. The New World Order is starting the Muslim nuclear winter. For the greedy, oily rollers, prophets, a gallon of gasoline in the U.S.A. will go for from $4 to $8 when this World War III starts. There it is. God's holy, holy, holy throne room, fresh manna from heaven. For the glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus, Savior Messiah. Thank you, God of Israel, for warning people. Blow the trumpet of Zion, Rosh Hashanah. This was yesterday. This is your warning. Thank you, God of Israel. Thank you, Jesus, Savior, Messiah. And God's word is confirmed. That's a new manna from heaven yesterday. Now we're going in God's holy Bible. And book of Joel in chapter 2. This happened 2,800 years ago when the prophet Joel gave this prophecy. And this is the new prophecy. Lines up with the prophecy on Muslim nuclear winter. You're going to see the nuclear mushroom clouds over the Middle East, over the world real soon here. Chapter 2 of Joel in the Holy Bible here, from verses 1 through 20. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for his nigh at hand. A day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and a thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people, and a strong, there hath not ever the like, neither shall there be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. A fire debarked before them, and behind them a flame burneth. The land is in the garden as the garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness, yea. And nothing shall escape them. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen so shall they run. Like the noise of chariots in the tops of the mountains shall they leap, like the noise of the flame of the fire that devoureth the stubble. As strong people set in battle array, before their face the people shall be much pained. All faces shall gather blackness. They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war. They shall march everyone on his way, and they shall not break the ranks. Neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk everyone in his path, and when they shall fall upon their sword, they shall not be wounded. And they shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter in at the windows like a thief. The earth shall quake before them. The heaven shall tremble. The sun and the moon shall be dark. The stars shall withdraw their shining. And the Lord shall utter his voice before his army. For his camp is very great. For he is strong that executes his words. For the day of the Lord is great and very terrible. And who can abide it? Therefore also now saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fastings, and with weepings, and with mourning, and rent your heart, and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your God. For he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, having great kindness, and repenting him of the evil. Who knoweth if he will return and repent and leave a blessing behind him, even a meat offering, a drink offering unto the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that suck the breath. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber, and the bride of her closet. Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep before the porch and the altar. And let them say, spare thy people, O Lord, and give not thine heritage to reproach, and that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their God? Then will the Lord be jealous for his land and pity his people. Yea, the Lord will answer and say to his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil, and you shall be satisfied therewith, and I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen. But I will remove far off from you the northern army, and will drive him into a barren, to a land barren. They talk about Russia right there, and desolate, and with its face toward the east sea, and its hinder part toward the utmost sea, and its stink shall come up, and its ill savor shall come up, because he had done great things. And may God add his word upon his holy blessings upon his holy word. And the God of Israel will defeat the Russian army. The God of Israel will defeat the Syria army. The God of Israel will defeat the Lebanon army. The God of Israel will defeat the Iran army. There's God's holy word. There it is. There it is. May God bless his word forever and ever. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will stand forever and ever. That is the word of God today. Oh God, have mercy on the USA. Oh God, have mercy on her soul. Have mercy on Israel. The land of Mecca, honey, your Canaan land, Beulah land. Oh God, we love you. The promised land. Thank God for your water. Thank you. Wash us in your word. Wash us in your water. Wash us. God, with your Holy Ghost, the fire of God, your presence, Jesus, your anointing. This is your time. This is your time. Before the nuclear winter hits over there in the Strait of Hormuz, before the nuclear winter hits in the Middle East, in the Holy Lands, before the Muslim nuclear winter hits here, United States of America, all around the world, we're on the threshold that the Muslim nuclear winter clouds are gathering, the dark storm clouds. And we're going to see these mushroom clouds over the place. You're going to see them north, south, east, and west. But the God of Israel will help you. Jesus will save your soul. This is your time. Do it before you don't know if you're going to make it. It might be too late. A deathbed conversion. Do it right now. We got time. Well, it ain't yet the Muslim nuclear winter. We're on the brink of a Muslim nuclear winter. And we don't have to see the mushroom clouds coming at you in the sky. So say this prayer with me today. Time is running out. This time is short. We'll see this. I believe the prophecy, what it said, for God's glory. If it don't happen, Yom Kippur here on September the 26th, 2012, this could happen before November the 1st, 2012. This is urgent. This is a spiritual 911 call. Oh, in North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, turn your life over to the Lord. You've been running from God too long, too many years. This is your time. You Muslims and you Hindus and Buddhists and New Agers and atheists and pagans and heathens and secular humanism and atheists and your sinners, this is your time to accept Jesus Christ, your personal Savior. Time's just about ready to run out. There'll be days soon, there'll be time no more. It'll be over with. It'll be done. Game over. It'll be finished. Jehovah Jireh, He's in control. God of Israel's in control. Jehovah Jireh. Oh, He's our provider. Say this prayer with me. Say it. Confess with your mouth and believe your heart. And this is your time to accept Jesus Christ, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the Savior Messiah. Oh, King Jesus, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, I come humbly to your throne of your amazing grace to accept you as my personal Savior. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for forgiving me for my sin. Lord Jesus Christ, I repent from my wicked way. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for saving my soul. Thank you for writing my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank you, Lord, I'm born again. Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul. Amen, amen. You said that prayer. This is the greatest news. There's front page news up there in heaven. The angels go around blowing the trumpets. They're playing the harps. They're marching around the throne room. And for 10,000 years, we'll be marching forever and ever. You step to Jesus Christ, your personal Savior. I thank you, YouTube, for letting these videos go out for God's glory. I think this is the 71st video in a little over a year. Or maybe it's been a year. I think about 3 months, maybe 15 months. And thank you for this. It's a very anointed video prophecy on the Muslim nuclear winter here, 2012. Here it is. And if you said to Jesus Christ, come to George and Betty Culley's channel, on YouTube channel, website here. Write us. We have our address on there. Prophet George and Betty Culley, 407 South Douglas Street, Pinckneyville, Illinois, 62274. Email us. Our email is on the profile. For God's glory, email us. Lisa, the brethren there, with the A, yahoo.com. That is our email. Email us. Give a public confession. Give Jesus a praise report. Or write us. We love you. Jesus loves you, most important. And me and Betty Culley and Alicia Culley, I'll be praying for you, at least the brother ministry in Pinckneyville, Illinois. Be praying for us. We thank Jesus for you. It won't be long. You know, we still got freedom of speech and freedom of religion in the United States of America. We don't know how much longer we have, but we're going to blow the trumpet in Zion and sound his alarm in his holy mountain for repent for the kingdom of God's hand. We love y'all. God bless you. Have a good day. Thank you, Jesus.